I did not see that coming. Hey everyone, Templar74 here with another Yu-Gi-Oh! Video, and today's Yu-Gi-Oh! Video is going to be a discussion revolving around the big news that we got from Yu-Gi-Oh! Jump Fest earlier this week. And I gotta be honest with you guys, I watch Jump Fest every year. I'm a big Yu-Gi-Oh! Nut, and the news that we got on day one was way out of left field. Nobody saw that coming. We all thought that when Go Rush was teased that it was going to most likely be a video game, maybe a movie, but it's confirmed at Jump Fest now that Yu-Gi-Oh! 8 Go Rush anime will be the next Yu-Gi-Oh! Anime, and it will be revealed in April of 2022. That's right, everybody. Yu-Gi-Oh! 7's is going to end at the end of its second season, now making Yu-Gi-Oh! 7's the shortest Yu-Gi-Oh! Anime. A title most recently held by Vrains is being taken by Yu-Gi-Oh! 7's, and Yu-Gi-Oh! 8 really looks different. I must say that if what we're getting glimmers of is true, then it's really a breath of fresh air, and I'm sure Yu-Gi-Oh! Fans will be appreciative of it. Now, everybody thought that the next Yu-Gi-Oh! Anime may somehow miraculously be recentered on Master Rules. It would even go back to the previous studio. Let's be realistic, we all knew that wasn't going to happen. It's going to be the same studio that did Yu-Gi-Oh! 7, same music composer, same director, pretty much the same world, but from the looks of it, we're going to get a much more mature story and older characters to boot. Maybe not much older, but a little bit older, which, you know, that's yet to be seen, but if that's true, breath of fresh air. Anyway, I am going to not go into the story and the characters so much. I feel that Yu-Gi-Oh! Everything did a fantastic video on that, and I don't really want to repeat what he said, so I would just go, I would YouTube, go into the search bar, type in Yu-Gi-Oh! Everything, Yu-Gi-Oh! 8, and it'll come up. That being said, everybody, that video is fantastic. Check it out. That being said, I'm just here to give my initial thoughts on it. And my initial thoughts was, I did not see that coming. I am shocked. Overall, I don't know how to feel about this. I think Yu-Gi-Oh! 8, if it does follow the older storyline just a little bit, and it's a little bit more mature version of 7's, I think that would be fantastic. 7's for me has been, it's been a bit of a crapshoot. It's been great. There are some episodes where it's like WTF, but you know, it's just, it was a big turnoff for a lot of Yu-Gi-Oh! Fans just because of the style that it was in. The slapstick comedy, people weren't really a fan of that. And we arguably went back to a less mature storyline. If this ends up fixing those problems and it ends up improving on the Yu-Gi-Oh! 7's world and gives us something even better, Yu-Gi-Oh! 8 sets to be pretty promising. We also have learned that Yu-Gi-Oh! 8 takes place in space. That's new. And we've also learned that our main character not only looks older, he's not a human. Yeah, that's also a first. First time that a Yu-Gi-Oh! Protagonist has not been a human. But that being said, everybody, that's pretty much my reaction. It's just sensory overload. A lot of expectations, a lot of hype. I am a little bit sad that Yu-Gi-Oh! 7's is ending, not gonna lie. But overall, I'm pretty happy with this. Overall, everybody, I guess we'll just have to wait and see what we get. I look forward to going through the Yu-Gi-Oh! 8 adventure with everybody else, but those are just my thoughts. And as always, I want to hear yours. So, in the comment section down below, let me know what your guys' thoughts were about this week's episode. Did you love it? Did you hate it? Did you think it was just eh there? What were your thoughts? Just let me know in the comment section down below, because as always, I enjoy hearing from you. All right, everyone. As always, Templar74 signing off. Have a great day, everybody, and I'll talk to you all next time. Goodbye, everybody.